الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل جلاله ونستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهديه الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا عباد الله أنصحكم ونفسي العاثمة بتقوى الله حثكم وإياها على طاعته أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل جلاله ومعصيته وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أشهد أن سيدنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم عبده ورسوله اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين رضي الله عن صحابته الغر الميامين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين أما بعد يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب ولا الإيمان ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء من عبادنا وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم. The ayah is in Surah Shura. And this ayah in Surah Ash-Shura, Allah says, you know, translate the meaning generally. The ayah Allah says in it, مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ Before that, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا The meaning basically we have commanded a ruh, a spirit from our command. Ruhan min amrina. Awhayna ilayk. Ilayk who? An-Nabi al-A'zam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is telling him, or telling us as well, of course, that we have sent you a ruh from our amr, from our command. Ruhan min amrina. Ma kunta tadri mal kitab wala al-Iman. You did not know, or the literal meaning means, you were not aware of or you did not know what is al-book or al-kitab kitab you did not know the kitab wal al-iman and you did not know al-iman walakin ja'alnahu nuran nahdi bihi man nasha'u min ibadina but we've made it a nur that we guide to it whoever we want from our slaves our creations وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ And you surely guide to the straight path. This ayah really came to praise the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And what is, I don't know what the word is really to say, but some people who have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them some kind of understanding, they made it to degrade the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the ayah came to praise him and elevate him. Actually, to elevate, to show him who he is, to show us who he is, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, while others consider it a belittling. In what sense? Well, they said, the ayah specifically says, وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ You did not have an idea what the kitab is. You did not know what al-Iman is. So you did not have Iman before. Nor did you know the kitab. In other words, they said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he was announced, before he got the wahi, he was also mingling with the mushriks and also the habits of mushrikeen. Others said, no, no, not like that. But really he did not, yani he was looking for, searching for the creator. He was not mushrik, but he was searching for the creator. He did not know, huh? مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابِ You did not know what the book is, nor did you know the iman. So, there is no kitab and there is no iman. Others said, well, not exactly in between, but that's why he made so many mistakes and he, you know, he did one thing and then he said, change this, all this, because he did not know the kitab, nor did he know the iman. Like the Quran says, مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابِ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ Of course, these understandings is due to the increasing number of suhufis, self-learned through the books, basically, through the pages of the books. And of course, you know, we have, Allah blessed us with so many of them nowadays. Now, The problem is, of course, the understanding. First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wallahu ya'simuka minan nas. Every prophet, we believe that every prophet, and that's the whole ummah, every prophet has a ismah. Ismah means infallibility. Infallibility means that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and every other prophet of Allah is not subject to shirk in any way, shape or form. Period. Number two, that the Prophets alayhi wa sallam ajma'een are not subject to disobeying Allah. Not because of the capacity in a sense, but because of the asma in a sense. Of course, now this is a little bit deeper topic, but let's go to the other point here. The other point is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the beginning, then what was he? And that's why you see these people who went to different opinions, they got ready, they didn't know, they were swinging. What should we say? Huh? Was he this? Was he that? Did he not know? Did he not know? Why did he? Huh? Versus al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet, is a Nabi. What I mean by prophet, I mean Nabi. وَآدَمُ بَيْنَ الرُّوحِ وَالْجِسَدِ as the hadith that is authentic says. And this hadith is authentic, is known. When he was asked, he says, كُنْتُ نَبِيًّا, I was a prophet. وَآدَمْ مُنْجَدِلٌ فِي طِينَتِهِ. One riwayah that he was still a clay. Another riwayah that وَآدَمْ بَيْنَ الرُّوحِ وَالْجِسَدِ, and Adam was between the soul and the body. يعني he was not created yet. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a prophet. Now, some scholars, Allah forgive us and them, and guide us and them to the best, they want to say, well, yeah, he was a prophet in the taqdeer of Allah and in the ilm of Allah. Yani, yeah, sure he was a prophet, but in the taqdeer, fil qudra ilahiyya, fil ilm ilahi, he was a prophet. Allah willed in his eternal knowledge that he's a prophet. Why? If that was the case, then what is the meaning of the hadith? Because we were all in the ilm of Allah. You and me and everything. This thing was created in the ilm of Allah that is eternal and everlasting. Not only the Prophet, also Adam was there, wa Isa, wa Musa, wa Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And every single creation is in the eternal everlasting knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what's the difference then? The hadith will have no meaning. But the hadith is khususiyya. The hadith is a uniqueness to tell you the uniqueness of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, "Kuntu, I was a prophet, wa Adamu bayna al-ruhi wal-jasad, and Adam is between al-ruh and the jasad." If it was the same thing that, well, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was first because he was written first, or because in the ilm of Allah first, number one, no.